Hey you guys, it's me Shania and I'm back again with part two of how to make your full torso block. So in part one, I showed you how to make the front part of your torso block. But in this tutorial, I'll be showing you how to finish it by creating the back part of the block. I am also offering standard US sizes 4 through 16 for free on my website. So all you have to do is just head over to my website, download it, cut it out, tape it together, and you have a pattern block for yourself. Draw a 3-inch horizontal line at the top of your paper and we'll call this line A. From the beginning of line A, measure and mark 1 inch down. We'll call this mark B. Be sure to use the right angle of your ruler to make sure that the 1 inch mark that you make is accurately placed. Draw a curved line to connect the end of line A to point B. Place your full torso front block that we made in part one on top of the paper so that mark E from the front torso block, aka the edge of the neckline near the center fold, is directly next to the end of line A. After you've placed your full torso block down onto your pattern paper, you want to just trace all around the edge. And be sure to transfer the following marks. You want to transfer the mark Q notch, the beginning and the end of the chest line, the bust line, the waistline, the dart points, and mark S. Use a pointy object like a pair of scissors in order to engrave the dart points and mark S. So once you have finished engraving those points, you can go ahead and put away the front torso block. My camera went blurry, but I just titled that notch with the letter Q, and then I'm using my ruler to draw a straight line, and I'm using the marks that I copied from the full torso front block as a guide to make the straight lines, and then I'm just retitling the straight lines, the chest, the bust, the waist, and then the hip line. And then I am transferring the dart points as well as the mark S. So we just want to go ahead and close up this gap. So we're just going to draw a vertical line that connects mark B to the place where we stopped tracing the front full torso block. So starting at mark Q, you want to make a mark that is about a half inch to the right of mark Q. Just make sure that your ruler is properly lined to the start of mark Q. Don't make the same mistake that I made. We'll call this mark C. Use a curved ruler to draw a curved line that connects the top and bottom of the armhole to mark C. So we've basically created our new armhole, and I'm just going to put a double notch so that when it's time to cut it out, I won't get confused. Starting at the beginning of the chest line, you want to measure and mark the bust band divided by 2. We'll call this mark D. Starting at mark D, you want to measure and mark 1 inch below mark D, and we'll call this mark E. Now you want to connect mark E to each dart point to form the top of your dart. To form the bottom of your dart, you want to connect mark S to each dart point as well. And now I just went ahead and I rounded out my neckline a little more, and I'm just gonna title this as a full torso block, and we know it's for the back and we need to cut on the fold. We have the green line and we know that there is no seam allowance, and we're just gonna cut all around the pattern, and that is it. We have completed our torso block. Thank you guys so much for the love and the support, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Ciao.